Amazing, Sheikh. The second thing I learned from you is that, you know, during our trip, I broke your tripod. Now, I know you love the tripod, right? And I was wondering, what am I going to say to Sheikh? You know, my heart was like, boom, boom, boom. And I just spoke to you and I was like, Sheikh, the tripod is broken, but who will get another one? And you know, the thing, what you said was, you see, there is khair in it, there is khair in it, there is khair. You always, whenever a situation happened, you always said there is khair in it. And it made me remember the saying of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, innama sabru inna sadmatil ula. Like, you know, our patience is at the beginning of the calamity, not in the middle of the calamity. You know, how are you able to build this quality? What comes to your mind always when a tribulation happens?
Look, whatever I do, I try and draw cue from the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. One of the things that I learned, let me give you this example. I looked for a tripod. I went myself. I was in the UAE in Dubai. I purchased what I thought was the best and I got what I thought was exactly ideal for me. And actually, everything comes with a plan. Before I was born, Allah has created these tests and He knows what's going to happen to me completely. Allah's knowledge, يَعْلَمُ مَا كَانَ وَمَا يَكُونُ وَمَا لَمْ يَكُنْ إِذَا كَانَ كَيْفَ يَكُونُ. Allah knows everything. What happened, what will happen, what will not happen. Everything He knows. So when you told me, and I saw it, and just as I saw it, you told me, the tripod is broken. What did I say? Say, Alhamdulillah.
Exactly.
Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. This is material thing. You damaged the vehicle, you broke the phone, you smashed it. There is something good about it that you don't know. You don't know. I may not know. Not now. You have to say Alhamdulillah. Okay? Forget about anything else. First, Alhamdulillah. أَيْنَ الَّذِينَ كَانُوا يَحْمَدُونَ اللَّهَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. On the day of judgment, try to be from among those who will be called out when they used to say Alhamdulillah upon all conditions. So it's an opportunity for you to show Allah that, oh Allah, your decree, I'm excited about it. I may not understand it. I'm a human. It's considered a material loss. Big deal. I have not lost my link with Allah. Why should I shout you? It broke. And I wasn't expecting it to break, but I know why it broke, because of some stampeding.
Yeah.
And to be honest, we can always replace it. If not now, then later, you know. And we were in, it was a rural part of Nigeria, right?
Yes.
In the north. And what happened is, you told me that, I said, we'll get another one, don't worry. You said, but we will have to wait to go to the capital city. I said, no, you will find one here. I know you will, because there are so many people on social media, so many people. It might not be the same quality, and we got a replacement straight away.
Indeed, indeed.
Look, and imagine if I got upset, I was even saddened for a minute because my tripod broke. Big deal, my brother. So I like to always remind myself, thank Allah. Oh, nothing negative can happen to a mu'min. Nothing, never. Someone dies, your bones break, your car is smashed, you lost your job, your everything went wrong according to dunya terms. Wallahi, according to Allah, it went how He planned it. How He planned it. Thank Allah, it could have been worse. Imagine my bone broke instead of that thing breaking. You know, I would have still said Alhamdulillah first to start with. May Allah protect us all. It's a tough one, but I'm just letting, I hope I would. And then we say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And we work towards improving the situation. So that I've developed that habit over time. Before, I may not have been exactly like that, but I've developed it over time. You know, when we did our tests for coronavirus, we were together.
Yeah.
And I was prepared. What did I tell the brothers? I said, brothers, if we test positive, we will quarantine together 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and no problem. Everything can wait because health comes first. But we will continue to do our da'wah even while we are isolated or while we are in quarantine, whatever else it may be. And subhanAllah, the results came negative and we were happy. Hence, we are sitting here together. We've been together anyway for the last so much. So may Allah make it easy.
Ameen, ameen.